Broad Peak is one of the most climbed 8000ers. It's close to K2, and those who climb K2 in summer often use Broad Peak as a training mountain. However, like all great mountains, it shouldn't be underestimated. Dramatic events have kept our attention on Broad Peak for the last 4 days. Further details have emerged. Others will surely come. Here's what we know so far about the summit climb and the accident that led to the death of Kim Hong Bin. July 17th. First attempt fails. The first summit attempt failed because of the slow pace through the waist-deep snow. Karakoram Expedition's leader, Mirza Ali, praised Don Bowie and Lota Hintsa for their efforts, but mentioned that many others refused to help. In the end, all climbers had to retreat to Camp 3 after a huge effort. The British team Cumbria to Broad Peak says that on July 17th, they had to help with several emergency rescues. Meanwhile, the Korean team, consisting of 6 Koreans plus the supporting staff led by Kim Hong Bin, set up Camp 4. July 18th. Despite conditions, the Karakoram Expedition rope fixers and many climbers headed back toward the top. This time, they succeeded. Oswald Rodrigo Pereira was among them. The three of us made it to the summit at 3:15 p.m. without oxygen and after 2 days of incredibly hard work, and were the first ones of the season, Pereira wrote. Anastasia Runova of Russia and Saulius Damulevicius of Lithuania reached the top quite late in the day, according to some reports. Monika Witkowska of Poland had to turn around when her O2 system failed. On the way down, she fell and slid down some hundreds of meters. She was unharmed and continued down on her own. The Death Zone Freeride members Vitaly Lazo and Anton Pugovkin eventually turned back too. It was late in the day and snowfall was increasing. They reached Camp 3 at about 10 p.m. and fell asleep right away. But not for long. The Russian skiers helped in 2 rescues of descending climbers. First, Anastasia Runova fell and lost her crampons in the process. Lazo and Pugovkin helped her and treated her in Camp 3. Later, a second SOS put the Russians on the move again. Kim Hong Bin had fallen somewhere and was unreachable. Lazo took some oxygen and hurried to the site of the accident, Pugovkin reported. However, all efforts were fruitless and Kim died. Kim was a famous climber for many reasons. He had lost all of his fingers and toes on the cold summit of Denali, Alaska, and was completing the last 8000er that was missing from his curriculum, the Broad Peak. He therefore would have been the first disabled person to climb all 8000ers. The climbers who were with Kim and Drunova will have to clarify the exact times and locations of the accidents. Early reports posted by Pugovkin in Russian suggested that Kim might have fallen into a crevasse. Both Anastasia and Mr. Kim fell at the same place, down a cornice above the saddle on the summit ridge, she explained. This was precisely where Leonard's and Ashurli mentioned that the route became exposed and scary. Saulius Damulevicius mentioned in his own report that Kim summited Broad Peak at 5 p.m, only 2 hours before dark. After he fell, Damulevicius went on. Kim stayed all night on a ledge on the Chinese side, where Broad Peak's wall falls all the way down to the glacier. Anastasia Runova fell there and was rescued by a Pakistani guide, but Mr. Kim for some reason wasn't. That Kim remained there all night is coherent with the time that Pugovkin reported the attempt at rescue on the following day. We don't know whether Kim's team was with him when he fell, and how they tried to help. Apparently, Lazo tried unsuccessfully to drag him back up the ridge, and remained with him all night. Runova also mentions that a helicopter was considered, but Kim had no helicopter rescue insurance. Eventually, Pugovkin decided to join Lazo at the accident site. But Runova posted that around noon, the Korean could not be saved. He fell, and the weather was getting worse. Few people are willing to discuss the incident, but it does appear that Kim was alive for several hours after his accident.